Welcome to another video by Patty Cunningham. I am here to show you today how I would paint a rusty lock on a weathered barnwood door. One of the first things we have to do is start with choosing our paint colors. And since I work with a limited palette, I have to figure out how to make that turquoise out of my combination of blues and greens. And what I chose to do is use perlene green and amend it with a lot of cerulean blue to get that turquoise color, and I think it comes pretty close. One of the things you'll see me do is when I initially mix my puddle of paint, I don't quite make enough. So consequently, I have to go back and remake some more paint, and it comes out slightly different in color. But I fix that in the end by putting another layer over top. The far right and the far left sides of this painting are out of focus, which helps us to zero in on the lock and the shadow behind the lock and the hook the lock is hanging on as our focal point. So in order to do that, I first wet the area behind the that I'm going to put paint into on the right side, and on the left, then I add the aqua color, turquoise color, initially. After that, I'm going to do lots of additions of blemishes and light spots, more of that at the end. I tend to attack the painting in sections, so I'll do one little delineated section, and in this case they're delineated by the lines of the boards, and when I do the smaller sections I don't need to wet them first, especially because these little sections have more sharp resolution of the lines and the holes and the bumps, so I just do wet on dry in these little spots. Next, we move into the lock and the hook part, and we're going to put on the aqua color everywhere we see it on the lock and on the hook. Thank you. I'm still working with my first layer of the aqua. I'm going to go back to the first part I did, which is the far right hand blurry section of wood, and I'm going to put another bit of tone in there just to give it a little more depth. I'll probably put a little texture in there, and then I'm going to blend all the edges. Now I'm going to go into the second color combination, which is quinacridone burnt orange and ultramarine blue. They're going to make up the majority of the rest of the painting. Different combinations, different percentages of each color, different amounts and percentages of water to get lighter or darker effects. So I'm going to start with this weatherwood part on the right and see where that takes us. Here you're going to see me add some yellow to this little section of weathered wood. That was a mistake. It was too bright and it brought too much attention to that spot, so ultimately I removed some of it and then covered it over with something not yellow, something more brown. Now moving on to the metal pieces, I needed to take a combination of the quinacridone burnt orange and ultramarine blue, but much more toward the blue-black side. So I had to make a new, I had to adjust the color and get it darker, in other words less water, and start laying in the blacks of the metal. After laying on the color, lifting out a few lines will help give the piece form and show how the light is impacting it. The majority of the time painting was spent on the weathered wood, so here I'm starting in on a piece right behind the bolt. And I'm adding another layer of the aqua, but I'm also using kind of a little bit of wet on wet right around the where the hook, the bolt meets the wood, to give it some depth and let the viewer know that it is connected there to the barn wood. Again, I'm laying in a clean wash of water before I put the color in. The body of the lock is done with stippling and dry brush, many colors working light to dark. Thank you. all different combinations of quinacridone burnt orange and ultramarine blue. Time to put a little shadow on the top of the lock. For the really important shadow, the shadow of the lock on the weathered wood. Thank you. The rest of the painting is going to involve weathering the wood, so we're going to add little nicks and dents and pops of color pops of brightness by lifting color out. That comes at the very end. And then we're going to make sure to bleed all the edges on the far right and the far left to give that blurry effect. The shadow was a little dead looking, and so I coated that when I coated the rest of the weathered wood with more turquoise. I also ran a glaze of the turquoise over the shadow. Final work involved putting a lot of cerulean blue marks on the far left-hand blurry side to give the depth over there, and a lot of lifting, and just a lot of effort to make the wood look really old and sun-drenched. After all that was complete and a few more touch-ups were done, we have the completed painting.